The Honourable Member for Arthur-Virden.
Madam Speaker, I rise here today inspired by the vision of Henry J. Moore, the concept of an international peace gardens. In 1929, at the heart of this continent, a vision of an international gardens association, they turned his plans and sketches of a garden that would tell a story, peace between two great countries, into reality. In 1932, the unveiling of a cairn built by Fieldstone by students from both Canada and the United States of America was situated right on the 49th parallel. This marked the creation of an international peace gardens. The cairn located at the site reads, "To God in His glory, we two nations dedicated this garden and pledge ourselves that as long as we shall live, we shall not take up arms against one another." This is a reminder of how we all must work together for peace for all our citizens. At the opening, a crowd of 50,000 people came to celebrate this momentous occasion. The International Peace Garden is located at the heart of the Turtle Mountains in my constituency of Arthur-Virden. It's a perfect place to gather, meet, and experience and promise of peace created more than 80 years ago. With more than 100,000 visitors each year to enjoy the 2,300 acres of exploring, adventure, and history. The Peace Garden plants over 150,000 flowers each summer. Guests are invited to enjoy the ever-changing display. Each year, the International Peace Gardens hosts many events, including the International Music Camp, the International Sports Camp, Square Dancing, Envirothons, and horticulture programs, to name a few. This gem on the map also features a Peace Chapel, a 9/11 memorial site, and many different water gardens that make up the relaxing surroundings. They have they're fully stocked gift shop for all your souvenir needs and a restaurant to sit and dine. For more information on their website, visit www.peacegardens.com. The International Peace Gardens is a must-stop for all ages. Special thanks goes out to Gary Enns, his staff, and many volunteers for continuing to make the international tourist attraction an amazing place to visit. Thank you, Madam Speaker.